You cannot industrialize when you cannot produce enough electricity to feed your industry. It's a basic rule of the game. Energy policy is therefore going to be very critical. And when we, in the process of economic transformation, we have to be self-sufficient, at least in our energy needs. And that requires a continued investment in energy. China, for example, invests about $20 billion every year in energy. Every year, $20 billion, just to keep up. So we have a lot to do. You cannot compete globally when a basic infrastructure like water is a problem in your economy. Those are rules of the game. You have to have these in place to have a well-functioning economy. You cannot compete if you do not have a very formalized economy. And the MPP is going to move very quickly under the Nkwale to formalize the Ghanaian economy in the first step. The national ID system, which we enacted in 2008, is totally not been implemented. We have to do it at least within the first 2 years. It has to be something done and polished off. You cannot really run an economy with a highly informal system, and that whole national ID system should help formalize the economy. The address system in Ghana, you know, when you operate in the financial sector, just think about it in Paris or France today. Just ask yourself the question, what if you then went out and all the address system in Paris disappeared? You don't know where to find which goal. The economy would virtually collapse overnight. So there are so many businesses that depend on address systems. And in Ghana, we have so far treated the address system as almost a luxury and not a necessity. With the technology that is available today, the Google Maps and all of that, we should be able to put together an address system in very quick time. And the MPP government is going to stop paying lip service to this issue and actually implement it very quickly. Another major area that we are lacking in is the speed with which we adopt technology. The global competition that we see is a competition of skills. It's a competition of technology. At the heart of the competition of skills is the education policy. Countries compete depending on their human capital. It's not oil or cocoa or timber or gold that develops countries. It is people who develop countries. And our education system so far has excluded the vast majority of our people. So many potentially talented people have not been able to participate fully in society because of lack of access to education. And this is why Nana Addo has said that as a flagship policy, we are going to do two things. First, we are going to redefine what basic education means. And the redefinition of basic education is from kindergarten to senior high school. That is a new concept. So when you enter kindergarten, the first place you will get a certificate is when you leave senior high school. And secondly, we are going to make sure that the cost of that education is free to make sure that access is guaranteed. There were many who were questioning whether this was possible. It is possible. Do you see people questioning whether the national health insurance system was possible? They refused to vote for it. It is possible. We've done our numbers. It is going to be done by the grace of God. Is teachers, because we just don't want free education, we want free quality education. Free quality education means paying attention to teachers, making sure that teachers are well motivated to teach and have the infrastructure and their facilities to actually execute their jobs. So it's going to be the education policy is actually called Teachers First. That's what's in the manifesto. Because without paying attention to teachers, you are not going to get it. And we also have to use technology to make sure the teachers do their work. I mean, there's no reason why we shouldn't have Wi-Fi in every school in the country. There's no reason why the lectures from my shorter prep pair, fancy before the best schools should not be on the internet. We should use technology to advance our country. So it is going to be, ladies and gentlemen, we are going to enter an era of technology adoption and acquisition. The Japanese did it in 1868 with the Meiji Restoration when the Emperor Meiji came in. Japan moved full speed towards attracting technology and not penalizing people for bringing in technology, and we have tended to do so. If we are going to make Ghana the manufacturing hub of West Africa, which is what we are planning to do, then we have to encourage people to bring in the technology that will basically set up the factories that will produce those things. In bringing in that technology, whether it's for factories, for construction, for agriculture, or for education, or for health, we have to encourage the bringing in of that technology. So import duties on all of those equipment must be free. That is the one. Set up